You just bought a brand new iPad Air 6 and you're looking for a great keyboard. Well, you are in the right place because I have the Combo Touch for the iPad Air 6. We're going to unbox it, see what we like about it, what we don't like about it, and we'll also figure out whether or not you can use the old version of the Combo Touch from the iPad Air 4 or the iPad Air 5 with your brand new iPad. So let's get started. Now, today's video is broken out into different sections. We're going to talk about one, what's in the box. What do you get when you buy the Logitech Combo Touch? We'll talk about the key features. We'll talk about compatibility with older models. So if you have an older model and you're looking at that kind of the big trackpad that it offers, we'll talk about that as well. In addition to doing what are the downsides of this keyboard, and then finally wrapping up with a recommendation. This is the Combo Touch for the iPad Air 6, specifically designed for the iPad Air 6. And let's see how it fits and get an idea for it. I have not even looked at it yet. Oh, wow. That trackpad is quite big and it's quite different. This is for the iPad. Yeah, this is for the iPad Air 6. Had to make sure they didn't grab the wrong one because I do have one for the iPad Pro, but it's different because the camera is different here. Now that we have the Combo Touch for the iPad Air 6 seated inside of the case, we'll go through a few of the features. So this is all polyurethane outer. Here, this is like a hard plastic. It's a different material, but it is different indeed.
It includes a kickstand with multiple viewing angles, and those viewing angles extend from 10 degrees to 60 degrees, from a very low angle for sketching to a high angle for FaceTime.
Now, also the trackpad here is a little bit bigger. We'll get the exact measurements in just a few moments here, but the trackpad on the new version is a little bit bigger, and there's a little bit different key layout, which we'll go through here in just a moment as well. If you have an Apple Pencil and you put it here, there is nowhere to secure the Apple Pencil. What I would suggest is that there are these Apple Pencil sleeves, which you could put and adhere onto the back, which will hold your Apple Pencil in place while you travel with your Logitech Combo Touch. Now, a lot of people in my previous video, where I reviewed this for the Combo Touch for the iPad Pro, were like, hey, can I use one with the other? So here is the Logitech Combo Touch fan favorite case. I was using this with the iPad Air 4. This one's my wife's, and we're going to... So first and foremost, it looks like it fits perfectly. So I have the iPad Air 6 inside of this case from 2 years ago. That fits. I'm typing on the keys and they work fine. I was able to take the Combo Touch from 2021 and put my iPad Air 6 in here and it works just fine. So, which is nice.
Before I go on, if you are enjoying today's video, like I hope you are, consider subscribing to the channel as I'm trying to grow from 25,000 to 50,000 before the end of the year, and I would appreciate your support. Now, back to the iPad Air.
So we're looking at the Combo Touch from last year here on my left, your right, versus the one that's brand new for Logitech that just came out for the iPad Air 6. On my right, your left. We're just gonna take a look at the keys and measure to see if there's any remarkable differences.
The trackpads are almost identical at the width of 112, but the new model has a slightly taller trackpad.
But let's just take a look here at the top row of keys. The keys look to be almost the same. There's a few differences in the keys, the functionality. So here we have focus mode goes into do not disturb versus lock. We have the volume control keys. We have the media control keys. And then the next difference we have here is going to be screen brightness, which is on the old one, versus screenshot and Siri. Then we have keyboard brightness, and then we have screen brightness on the iPad itself. And the key depth is still the same. It should be 1 millimeter of key travel. So the trackpad itself sounds different for sure. It does seem to click everywhere on the trackpad, which is nice. It's not like a springboard trackpad where you have to click at the bottom, which is also nice. It does support tap to click, which is a great feature. So if you just want to, instead of clicking down, you just tap on the trackpad itself. Like I would go like that, and it would open up. Let's take a look at the magnets. Are their size a little bit differently? Same thing here. All right, let's look at the back. There's some magnets there. And that's what's gonna hold this case closed. So the magnet array seems to be exactly the same on both devices.
Is the end of the day, you need to make a decision on whether or not the Logitech Combo Touch is the right keyboard for you. At $199, it is a premium option. It's not as expensive as the Magic Keyboard for the iPad Air, which is $300. But I would suggest this keyboard to most people based on a couple different things. So one, it's gonna connect to your iPad using the Pogo pins on the back of your iPad. Those are those little pins that are right here. That means that you do not have to charge this. It's always gonna use your iPad's internal battery. But what that also means is that there is no battery inside of this. and you cannot use the iPad keyboard. You cannot use the keyboard if it's disconnected from the case, which is good and bad. This does offer four different viewing modes. It's view, sketch, read, and type, allowing you to use this in multiple contexts, which is great for majority of people. The thing that you need to be aware of is that if you are a lap typer, that means you're, you know, balancing this on your thighs while you are typing. You do need to balance this in two different positions. You need to balance the hinge itself, and then where's the hinge at? The hinge itself and this bottom of the case. So if you are, you know, moving your legs around and they're uneven, it will have a hard time keeping the keyboard, you know, level to your or parallel to your legs. So that's the thing I would consider about that. There is nowhere to store your Apple Pencil other than the magnet. There's no latch or anything, no secure space to store it. But I do have something that I would suggest to you. It's a sleeve from ESR. It is adhesive and it adheres right here to the back of it. I'll put a link right below this product, which you'll find in the video description down below. Other than that, I think this is the keyboard for most people, including you. Let me know what questions you have down in the comments below. Now, if you want to learn more about how to be productive on your iPad, I've got a video right here for you. Otherwise, YouTube is suggesting this video down here, which is really my favorite video, and I think that you should watch that next. Guys, my name is Mike, and I will talk to you in the next one.